I couldn't believe what I was watching.
I remember the first time I walked on the volume and I was like, wow.
You can literally take actors into a real space whilst not being there.
Well, I tried to describe it to my son and I just said, oh.
It's like the biggest TV you'll ever see, and we just act in front of it.
You see the whole landscape in front of you, so you're really looking at the sea.
And it looks real. It really looks real.
The first issue we were facing was the pandemic that happened, that turned this world upside down. We wanted to make a European show with a European cast and a European crew. Wanted actually also to travel all these places where we wanted to shoot and just realize, wait, we can't do that anymore.
The story was always set in Europe with an international ensemble shot with multiple languages. We always knew that this is a core idea behind 1899 and makes it genuinely attractive for the audience. When we started early prep and went into the writing process, we just had our first lockdown. How can you shoot a pan-European show in a pandemic?
Hopefully, I've got something to send you. Josephine sent me from Denmark. There's no quarantine over there, so it looks like yes. We might be able to go to Denmark.
Every production, it's always a headache. It's always a crazy puzzle. But in COVID, it's insane. You're not only dealing with people who are going to be in other shows or traveling from their own countries, they've got families, you're also dealing with quarantine. Quarantine when they go home, quarantine when they come to us. So if someone's coming to shoot 2 days, you're taking them out for 3 weeks. That's when the volume started to be talked about.
Someone at Netflix told us about the volume technology. At the beginning, we didn't really take it seriously, to be honest, because we were more like the very traditional filmmakers. Anything that can be done in camera, we preferred. Like, we really hate green screen.
Venturing into something that's completely new is very difficult, and it helps if the people at the table understand what each and everyone is talking about.
Netflix has a great team of executives who are specialized in helping filmmakers to push the boundaries and figuring out how the technology works.
There hasn't been any, no, can't do this, can't do that, just trying to make it happen. 100% trusting what Bo and Jantje wanted.
Ah!
The volume is built in the oldest building complex here on the lot. It's a Marlene Dietrich Stages, built 1910. Fritz Lang's Metropolis was shot in there. They used on these stages rear projection. The volume itself is a development of that technology. It's rear projection brought into the future. We have 350 square meter shooting area, 270 degrees of viewing angles, and as an industry first, a revolving stage which can basically move the entire set and enable the filmmaker to shoot 360 degrees in whatever environment he could think of.
The other great thing that we have in here is a rain rig. And this is something where I think nobody believed in but Bo, that this is possible.
If you know how green screen productions are usually made, you know that having atmospheric effects in front of the green is not possible. Being able to see reflections in the eye of the cast members, seeing reflections on the ground, on the wet floor, being able to see the natural look of rain hitting the costume of a character, and having that in camera at the end of the shooting day is, I think, the biggest advantage of the technology. Our virtual production sets are all daisy chained in the shooting schedule. We try to bring them into the stage as fast as possible and get them out as fast as possible. We have a total of 30 sets going into the volume and out, filling 30% of the season. Being able to do that all out of Germany, out of Potsdam-Babelsberg, is amazing. It will save so much carbon emissions. It helps us keep the production stable. It's reliable. We are not dependent on weather. It will just enrich the way the story can be told.
And landscape!
truth lies behind these walls. There's no reason to be afraid. This isn't real.
Remember?
The brain is wider than the sky. For put them side by side, the one the other will contain.
When I'm writing, I'm usually personal. I'm trying to put on the paper what I feel or think. I'm Maura in a way, I'm that story, and it is about creating something, like the process of creation. What does that actually mean? How does it work? How free are you? What can you do? And now I have the freedom to just do whatever. I can just create any kind of space, and it's just a fabulous playground. It's like being a child again and just let your imagination run wild to the wildest places.
Even in the writing process, we specifically generated scenes which, you know, in the past you will not be able to shoot in that way. You can now shoot everywhere. You can even go to Mars, to New York if you want, or into the dystopian future. It will enable local filmmakers, and I think the future of the technology lies in these markets.
That's a completely new level of creating and writing.
This can't be real.
I could define directions like this for A.
When you do work in a virtual production, you have to create content beforehand. You're kind of pulling post-production up front before shooting.
It was new for everyone on both sides, on our traditional filmmaker side, but also on the side of the guys who are actually doing all the backgrounds, Framestore from London.
We started this when there was no script. Jantje was writing, the story was evolving, there was just an idea. With virtual production, we have to provide content, visual effects, before we film, so that on the day when we film, we have content that we can provide and get it in camera.
Ganz toll.
The basic key for me as a designer is that there is no virtual set and a physical set or different sets. There's a set, and the set is following the story.
Then rearrange and see.
The volume itself, it's logistically challenging. It requires far more prep time. You need to be close in contact with all your colleagues.
Working with Udo on the production design was a new experience, I think, for some of our artists, because they were used to receiving production designs and just translating them. In this case, for 1899, we were developing them from scratch with him. His sets needed to fit into our environments or our virtual sets, and our virtual sets needed to work with his.
It's a lot of fun to do it and see so many people being on it. Not that feeling, oh, car, fix it in post, or we do it now and then we see later what's going on. It's now or never, and you get the magic to be on the point. It's stressful, but the payoff is amazing.
Can you see my screen?
Yes. Can you show the LED wall just so I understand where it would be distance-wise?
Christian Kestner and the team of Framestore, they shaped all this in the beginning. So we had a lot of scoutings in a virtual world of where we want to go. What angles are we shooting? Where could we stand with the camera? Where we want
to
be?
This one is still the trickiest to sort out. So where's the shopping center? It's really fun. You're like a little child. You create worlds and then you feel like, oh, it's not real enough. And then you add stuff here and add there. And step by step, you're getting closer, creating a reality that doesn't feel like it was created, but it actually exists.
Could you go back?
You sent a screenshot of an area I really liked. Do you see that?
Bo was shooting ocean plates in Scotland, and the helicopter captured a valley that he really liked. He told us, you know, when we talked about Scotland, this is what I really would like it to look like. We decided very quickly, okay, let's go up there and scan the environment. So we did a drone scanning of the environment, photogrammetry. After that, we modeled and stitched the environment, and that's our background for Scotland.
Already much
much better. There's still some kind of strange plants, some stragglers.
I don't think it will ever replace traditional production. It will just be a constant part of the puzzle. I think there are environments and scenarios and scripts, especially in the episodic world, where virtual production has a place.
Mom, look! Look what I found.
To create something feeling naturalistic in a completely built environment is certainly a bit of a challenge. What is very important for me when it comes to the volume work is the pre-lighting, so that I have time to establish this world, to create the lighting here, and that whatever light mood is in the pre-production created on the wall is actually going into the foreground and they, you know, fit well together.
You know, we're still 1899, so there's no fluorescent lights or anything, so it should be all warmish. It's all fire-based lamps, basically.
The Hong Kong Harbor is my favorite set, I would say. The mood that is created, everything that is on the screens and the foreground are marrying so nicely together. It's just such an, yeah, beautiful scenery.
The ambience, the peacefulness of this set, the way Nick sees the light, how fast he works. They managed to create something that was so, I don't know, that was the most beautiful set I've ever seen in my life.
I was really fascinated at the beginning because normally for a story like this, you have completely everything is green screen or blue screen. It's special for us in the editorial to have shots kind of finished. It's easier to get more in the emotions. It's not that, well, okay, I see the studio, I see the boom, I see everything. It's not that technique, it's more feeling.
If you have the ocean not there and you have a green screen, you don't put any sound to it either. Where here you have an ocean, you know, you can do sound work, you can make it emotional already.
It's a huge help for us, so we don't have to travel to the desert, nor to the North Pole, nor to the glaciers and stuff. You can change that within a minute.
It's a very odd place to work at the beginning, but fantastic from an actor's point of view.
It creates, you know, the perfect lighting, you know, the perfect colors. It's just a perfect environment for the actors to interact with rather than just having to imagine it like we used to do when we were working with a green screen.
It's so real that I remember a lot of us, when we first stepped onto the volume, got seasick when we were watching the waves in the background go up and down.
I said to Izzy, I was like, I just can't believe that we've been able to make a series on here. You know, it's just, it's incredible. She was saying, oh, I want to do something on location next. And I said, I absolutely don't. I just want to stay in here.